To seek employment as a radio announcer, news person, sportscaster, or other on-air talent, generally some form of audition audio was required. Nowadays, it is probably delivered to the program director as an MP3 file posted to a file sharing service. Before that, a CD would be mailed to the radio station for review. Prior to that, most likely a cassette would be the method of delivery. Before cassettes, a reel-to-reel tape was provided containing the voice sample. And way before that, and what you are about to hear now, is an audition recorded to an acetate disc. There was no way to edit these discs, so if you made a mistake, you either had to start from scratch or lay the mistake on the disc. Let's go back to 1949 and listen to Lou Morton.
Well, here it is, the jukebox review. Latch on to your favorite band, a vocalist too. And if you're a square, you're a square, we're telling you. On the air, your jukebox review.
Music that's jumping, jiving hard. Our jukebox plays you all it's got.
You love songs that give with that low pretty stuff.
The nickel in the slot is on the cup. Each time we're on, we're sending you out of this world with the nation's head.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yes, here we are up here strictly from Dixie with another full 60 minutes of Jukebox Review with yours truly, Lou Morton. We'll be here today with more and more and more of the best in the way of a band from the heart of the nation's vacation land. So stick around. We'll be with you up until 4 with A Galaxy of Stars recorded and transcribed. We hope you'll enjoy our show. Thank you, Maestro, for giving me back the microphone, and we're going to get things all wound up here today, friends. Got a lot of requests in here to answer, and we're really glad to hear from you out there in Sunshine Land, so stick around for something to open with a bang. Here's the Illinois Jackette and the boys with King Jackette.
Yes, it's a good day. How could anything be wrong? A good day from morning till night. And it's a good day for shining your shoes. And it's a good day for losing the blues. Everything to gain and nothing to lose. A good day from morning till night.
Yes, it's a good day indeed, lovely Peggy Lee. And it's been a pleasure having you up here this afternoon on the old Jukebox Review. We've got the old music box all spun around here this afternoon, friends. Gonna put another nickel in the slot, open up another letter, and we see we've got a request for little friend Vicky up around Lake Worth way. She said something by Diz Gillespie. Here's that man with a nice goatee and the beret to do something called Lover, Come Back to Me. Mighty sweet trumpet, yes, mighty sweet indeed for the man that's king of bop, Diz Gillespie in the orchestra here on an RCA Victor label this afternoon. The jukebox is really rolling around right now, and here's one that comes from an album of recordings made from the motion picture of the same name. I suppose you've all been down to the local cinema to see A Song Is Born starring Danny Kaye. Well, all of the proceeds from this particular album, we're going to plug it from time to time, are going to the Damon Runyon Cancer Memorial. Getting our canyons and our runyons mixed up here this afternoon. But nevertheless, it's something done by Louis Armstrong and his All-Stars, and Louis and old Jack Teagarden are going to do the vocalization on A Song Is Born.
Jackson, what's that you're playing, Pops?
Well, you know, it's very interesting how a song is born.
Can't you kind of jazz it up a little?
It's just a tune and a word right from the mockingbird. That's how a song was born.
You see the old clock on the wall saying tick, tick, tock. Doc, you got to pack up the old wax and get on the road. So we're going to pick up the plaques and shove them back in the racks and remind you, we'll be back tomorrow afternoon from 3 and 4, more and more and more and more. Here's Illinois Jackette and the boys running things right on out with a jacket for Jack the Bellboy. Well, friends, we're sorry to say that it's farewell for now. This has been yours truly, Lou Morton, up here spinning the platter and giving out with a little bit of chatter. Tomorrow afternoon from 3 to 4, we'll be back with more and more and more. Music, of course, strictly off the record, and now it's show long and, most of all, good music. How do you do? My name is Lou Morton, and I thought just about here and now on this audition disc that I might tell you a little bit about myself. I have a little over 3 years' experience in commercial radio. I've worked at just about all phases in this period of time, but most of my work, however, has been confined to staff work. I have quite a bit of time in sports color and special events and stuff of that nature. I've done quite a bit of news, reading 4 or 5 newscasts a day, or newscasts, I might say, on this particular station. I've done a lot of disc work. In my career in radio, I have worked at 3 independent stations, 1 mutual network outlet. Therefore, I have a very good background, as far as disc jockey work is concerned. I'm 23 years of age, and I have 2 years of college. I come from a town in Ohio called Hamilton, Ohio. It's located right in the southern part, right outside of Cincinnati. At present, I'm working for a station here in South Florida, Wmbm on Miami Beach. I, however, am seeking a little bit better position, something more or less of a way of gain monetarily, you might say. At present, I make $200 a month salary, and I, of course, am seeking more. Any other thing in the way of particulars, character references, or anything that you would like, I may be able to obtain for you from the station that I am working in now, as well as references of instances in the stations that I have worked in the past. Thank you.
WJNO and WJNO FM, the Palm Beach voice of South Florida, West Palm Beach.